स्टार्ट।
मिस्टर डेप्यूटी चेयरमैन सर, आवर रेलवे सिस्टम इज द लार्जेस्ट इन एशिया एंड द फोर्थ बिगेस्ट परहैप्स इन द होल वर्ल्ड, एम्प्लॉइंग अबाउट 20 lakhs ऑफ पीपल। इट वॉज रादर रिफ्रेशिंग टू नोट दैट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन अबाउट 7 years पीरियड ए बैलेंस्ड बजट हैज बीन प्रेजेंटेड। सर, दिस इज वेरी एनकरेजिंग, एस्पेशली वेन दिस हैज बीन डन विदाउट इंक्रीजिंग द पैसेंजर्स फेयर्स। हाउएवर, इट इज ए मैटर ऑफ सम कंसर्न दैट अबाउट 70% ऑफ द रेवेन्यूज टू द रेलवेज इज स्पेंड ऑन एस्टेब्लिशमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर अलोन, एंड दिस आस्पेक्ट हैज टू बी लुक्ड इन टू वेरी केयरफुली। सर, इट हैज बीन स्टेटेड बाई द रेलवे मिनिस्टर दैट द रेलवे एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इज नाउ सीइंग द एंड ऑफ द टनल। आई होप दैट दे आर सीइंग द एंड ऑफ द टनल इज नॉट एनी इल्यूजन। दे हैव ऑल्सो सेड दैट दे आर वर्किंग ऑन ऑल द सिलेंडर्स, बट अपेरेंटली टॉकिंग इन टेक्निकल टर्म्स, इट अपीयर्स दैट द सिलेंडर्स स्टिल लैक द कंप्रेशन, अदरवाइज द परफॉर्मेंस शुड बी मच बेटर। सर, देयर इज अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग ऑन विच आई वुड लाइक टू इन्वाइट द अटेंशन ऑफ द ऑनरेबल रेलवे मिनिस्टर एंड दैट इज द रेलवे बोर्ड। इट इज ए वेरी फैमिलियर एंड पॉपुलर टॉपिक ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म इन बोथ द हाउसेज ऑफ पार्लियामेंट। वेल सर, इट इज हाई टाइम दैट द मिनिस्टर एंड द गवर्नमेंट हैड अ सेकेंड लुक एट इट एंड लुक ए व्यू ऑन वेदर द रेलवे बोर्ड हैज सर्व्ड इट्स यूटिलिटी और स्टिल इट इज रिक्वायर्ड to serve the railways and the country. Sir, this utility has to be established and only then the railway board is to be allowed to continue. Otherwise, we will have to agree that it is only a white elephant. Sir, let us hope that these encourages financial results will continue to be encouraging till the end of the year. Although the railway financial authorities have not taken into consideration that impact of the additional dearness allowance which may have to be paid to the railway employees during the year, and if this is done, I am sure that the surplus that this budget has attempted to bring about will be upset and the whole working will be imbalanced and we will end up with a deficit budget at the end of the year. However, I am not much despondent about this matter, because the railway have been reconstructive in making the estimates from freight and passenger traffic, and if our hopes of getting additional revenue materialize, I hope it would be possible to provide adequate cushion for the payment of the increased dearness allowance which may be given to the railway employees in due course. Sir, for improving the image and the working results of the railways, they will have to work very hard. It is too early to expect that the budget will not have any inflationary impact at all. the gap between the revenue and the expenditure for the year 2004-05 is of the order of rupees 144 crores, and this is a very big gap, and I hope that this sort of performance will not be repeated during this year. As things stand today, and if past performance is any indication, the prospect of any striking improvement in the efficiency and productivity of the railway is still very doubtful. Let us hope that this doubt will not materialize. For instance, in the year 1995-96, the railways carried 200 million tons of goods traffic. But in the year 2005-06, it is estimated that only about 190 million tons of freight traffic will be carried. As against this decline in the amount of traffic carried, the employees increased from about 14 lakh to 20 lakh during this period, with the wage bill rising from rupees 350 crores to rupees 600 crores. Besides enormous investments in modernizing the equipment, acquiring new assets, then sir, the other phenomenon which I fail to understand is the employment opportunities for the minorities in the railways. The minorities used to form a very appreciable percentage of the total employment in the railways. But today, sir, I think the railway authority will have to try rather hard to work out the percentage for them. No doubt, sir, the Honorable Minister of State for Railways carries a lot of weight in the railway administration. But this weight is not at all balanced by a decrease in the employment opportunities for the minority communities. Sir, another important factor which I would like to mention is that efficient maintenance is the backbone of any transport system. It appears, however, that railway workshop have completely stopped doing any scheduled maintenance work for the last 2 years, and this has resulted in deplorable condition of coaches and wagons in many cases. Even the undercarriage maintenance is substandard.